Okay, I'm gonna preach. Here we go. Going to the pulpit here. There we go.
Dad, are you gonna break that chair? Dad.
What? I'm gonna break it. No.
Don't break
it. Okay. Alright, here we go.
Use the pencil. Use Dad. The microphone.
Where's the pencil?
It looks like you might break
it. You guys won't hear me if I don't use the pencil. Where's the pencil?
You're so soft spoken.
It's on the black thing.
It's on here.
Okay, here we go, guys. We're talking about. Make sure this thing works. Is it turned on? There we go.
Better tap it.
Okay. Testing. Okay. This is a perfect chair for me too, by the way, guys. Thanks for thinking of me. And a great pulpit. Fits me well. Okay. So, then he poured the water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and wipe them with the towel that was wrapped around him. Now, in this passage, Jesus, the Son of God, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, is about to get down and wash people's dirty, disgusting feet. They've been walking through the streets. Some of them probably walked through some cow dung, some dog poo. And they got it all over their feet and their sandals. Their feet are filthy with mud. Disgusting feet. And Jesus is about to take the place of a lowly servant. And he's going to get down with this bowl of water and a towel, and he's going to wash people's feet. He's going to get down like this. He's going to wash their feet with all the dog poo and all the cow dung. He's going to wash their feet, and he's serving them. Though he's the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords, he's humbling himself, saying, I love you so much, I'm willing to serve you, and I'm willing to wash your feet, that, come on, give me some feet, man. I want some feet.
I'll be Peter.
He's
Don't
willing.
Don't just wash my feet. Wash my head. Wash my arms.
Oh, but if you're clean already. That was strange. So Jesus is showing us something. He's showing us how to serve each other at the deepest and most humble levels, that we would all be willing to care for each other at the lowest levels.
Do you ever think that the only people in the Bible mentioned like washing feet were Mary and Jesus?
Mary and Jesus, yeah. So what can we learn from this? Oh, sorry. So what can we learn from this?
That Jesus loves us very, very much.
Yes. And what else?
To be serving.
At what levels do we serve?
The deepest.
The deepest levels. The most yucky levels, right? You know, Dad has to work on this. I'm feeling a little convicted because I don't like to change dirty diapers.
Serve Hosanna, Daddy.
Just remember, we've changed a million diapers and we've also washed your feet.
So even I need to grow in this area of being willing to serve at the deepest levels, getting dirty, working with disgusting things.
We
need to
clean
serve
the toilets
others.
Before long.
To clean the toilets. Huh?
Make sure to make it extra dirty.
Yes, ma'am? Use the mic so we can hear you.
This might be funny, but I had an idea for, like, to help you.
Okay. Oh, great. An idea to help me. I'm excited. Go ahead.
That you can wash all of our feet. I had an idea that you would go around with a towel and a bowl of water and then wash our feet.
Well, that's a good idea. We'll have to do that sometime. Did you mean right now?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Well, have I ever done that?
No. Maybe once. But we've watched
mom speak,
but
it would be good. Well, maybe that's a God idea. That'll help me.
Can we go get a bowl of water?
Yeah, that would be great.
I'll get it. I'll be Peter. I'll be acting out Peter.
Peter.
Okay, well, we're going to help Daddy with serving.
Should I use our popcorn bowl?
This is exciting. All right. Are your feet disgusting?
No.
Not really, huh?
I wiped my
Oh, that's too bad. Too bad. We need to go.
Can you
move
out?
Oh, it's hot, huh?
Is this okay?
Yeah.
I love you, Joshua. I love you. I feel very honored to be able to wash your feet. Your very special son. God has a wonderful and amazing purpose for you. And I'm very excited about what he's going to do in your life. And I want to learn how to be a better servant and serve you and what God wants for you and to lift you up. Should I get between your toes? All right, honey. I think I bless you in Jesus' name. I bless your feet. The feet, the Bible says that. What is the scripture?
How beautiful
are the feet of those who bring good news, who bring the news about Jesus coming to save the world. And you have those beautiful feet.
Maybe Bethany should go last because she got the dirtiest feet.
Okay. Well, the water turned a little bit different color. Come on.
Her feet are gross.
Oh, I can't wait. Thank you for letting me serve you and wash your feet.
It's not gross, but...
I bless your feet in the name of Jesus. And I bless you, Bethany. You are going to be an amazing truth teller. And you're going to tell the truth about God and His purposes to the world. And you're going to be a powerful, like... You're going to break the chains of the devil off of people. You are. You are a warrior princess. And I am so blessed to be able to wash your feet and love on you and serve you today. And I want to learn how to be a better servant. And I'm sorry for times when I didn't serve you very well. Will you forgive me?
Yes.
Thank you. All right. Those are amazing.
My feet are clean.
Your feet are clean. Okay, how about you put that one in there? I bless your feet to bring the good news of Jesus to the world. Not just to our neighborhood. To the whole world. And the power to break the chains of the enemy in Jesus' name. Hallelujah.
It turned a very dirty color.
Who's next? Jubilee! Okay, wait. Let's pull your pants up. There you go. All right. I am so excited about...
Use your towel on your waist.
About washing your feet, sweetheart.
We should have thought about that.
I'm so excited about washing your feet, honey.
We should have thought about that.
We'll get it later. I'm so excited about washing your feet. You know, you are such a special young girl. And you are very anointed. You are going to break the chains of the devil by your singing and by your strength. God has given you strength, Jubilee. And He's going to use it to deliver nations He's going to use it to deliver nations out of the grip of the enemy. And you are going to bring your name, Jubilee, to people. Jubilee means freedom. It means grace. You're going to bring it to them, Juby. Thank you for letting me wash your feet. I'm so happy.
It does.
It does?
Yeah.
I love you. Can I give you a kiss? With my hairy face?
On the feet. On the feet.
All right. Okay. Thank you. I bless your feet to bring the good news of Jesus to the whole world. To the whole wide world, Jubilee. I bless you in Jesus' name.
Do we need
any
more?
Nope.
CJ.
CJ. Oh, yay, CJ. All right. Thank you for letting me wash your feet.
Time, right?
Thank you for letting me wash your feet.
I know.
Wow. I feel so privileged. You know, you of all people, I've probably served the least because God has changed my life so much since you were born. But I was very selfish when you were born. And so I ask that you forgive me and that you don't learn from my mistakes, but you learn from Jesus and you become a man that is a great servant of others who has so much love inside of you and it just pours forth for people. I pray that Jesus will fill your heart with love and that you will totally feel that you are a son and that you're completely loved and accepted and lack nothing and that you would be a person who totally gives Jesus away so freely in Jesus' name. And thank you for letting me serve you right now. Thank you for letting me wash your feet. All right, I bless your feet to bring the good news of Jesus Christ to the world, to the world, to the world. God would use you powerfully, powerfully, especially in India, and that your heart would be open to whatever he wants, including preaching, and that you would not be afraid. You would know that you're a son and that you can make 100 mistakes and it doesn't change anything. You'd have to be afraid. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Ooh, all right.
I changed the different color now.
Jeremiah, the prophet, of mighty man of God. Thank you for letting me wash your feet. That's awesome. I'm so blessed. I'm so blessed.
Everyone go sit down.
I'm so blessed that you're letting me wash your feet. Thank you for letting me do this. Aren't you glad that Bethany had this amazing idea?
Yes.
Thank you for letting me serve you. You know, I have not served you as well as I could serve you. I know I've hurt you many times. And I'm sad that happened, and I'm sorry. And I ask that you forgive me. Your heart is so tender. I ask that you forgive me and that you would be, that these feet would be on a solid foundation of Christ's love and care for your life. And I thank you that you're letting me serve you now. And I pray that all the things that have ever hurt you, that even as I'm washing your feet, God would wash your heart and he would wash that hurt away and that you would be a mighty man, bold man of God who carries the word of God, who hears God's voice and brings people help and breakthrough and who is not afraid of anything. Not afraid of anything.
That would be nice.
That would be nice. So in Jesus' name I pray that as I'm washing your feet, Jesus would wash your heart and you would be just like him. Thank you for letting me wash your feet, Jeremiah. I bless your feet to bring the gospel of Jesus, the good news of reconciliation with God and man. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. You guys are going to do amazing things. I'm excited. I'm so glad I get to be your dad.
Hold on.
He's saying something.
You know what you could do to serve even more?
What?
You can make breakfast for us.
Wow! What an amazing idea. Well, Monday breakfast. I used to make Monday breakfast, huh?
Yes.
We'll see. We'll see.
Like old times.
It's just like old times.
Yeah.
All right. What?
No.
Wow, Sophia. What a privilege.
Last but not least.
Hey, you guys sit down, please.
You have loved me so much in all the things that you have done for me. I am so blessed. You are such a lover of people that if I asked you, Sophia, would you wash my feet? You would so do it. Like, you wouldn't even think twice about it. Oh, sure, Dad. Let me go get you some. Because you just love. And there's almost no restraints in your heart to love people. And I just bless you to have many opportunities to love people. And that you would reveal God's kingdom and God's heart to people. And that you would help them to know His love for you. And as I'm washing your feet, I pray that all the filth of the world that has gotten on you, anything that's discouraged you, any doubt and unbelief, how the devil has spoken to you. Juby, can you go sit down, please? How the devil has spoken to you and lied to you, I pray right now that all that would be washed off of you. As I'm washing your feet, it would be washed off, and your mind would be clean, and you would believe God like off the charts faith. Like, you would believe God and you would know, no, this is God. This is what He's doing. I'm not going to believe anything else but what God says and what He's doing. So I bless you with faith. I bless you with expressions of His love. I know His love's inside of you, but expressions of His love, that you get more opportunities and that people would not just think, oh, Sophia's a loving person. They would actually see the life of Jesus inside of you. And as you sing, I pray that heaven would come. That you would be like an angel who comes, and when you sing, it would be like you're hearing heaven, and it would bring breakthrough, and God's love would pour out on people's lives. Ha ha ha! That's so cool. Amen. That is exciting. Okay. I bless your feet to bring Jesus to the world. To the world. The world does not have a sin problem. They have a Jesus problem. We learned that yesterday, didn't we? Bless you. Amen.
Now
is there anyone left? Oh, there's one more person.
No.
Mommy.
This gets edited out.
There's one more person.
I
want
to
wash your
goodness. Oh, I got that.
There's one more person.
This gets edited out.
Okay. There's one more person. Everybody, sit down. Mom.
Wow.
Beautiful. Beautiful mom.
Some dirty water.
Thank you for letting me wash your feet. This is awesome. Like, you have washed my feet in all of your activities, in all your serving me, like, for what, almost 20 years, right? You have washed my feet for 20 years, and I have not I could do so much better. Definitely a lot of growth that I need in this area. And I ask that you forgive me. Let me wash your feet. And Lord, I just ask that you'd wash all the hurt that has come through my lack of care, my lack of love, my lack of serving. And I ask, God, that you just wash her heart as I wash her feet. And I thank you for her feet. And I thank you for her service. And I thank you for her love. And I ask, God, that you would bless her for her selfless work and her care for our home and for our children. I ask that you bless her and that you would fill her with your spirit. And you are an amazing woman. You are an amazing woman. And God is going to use you in amazing ways. He is melting your heart into his heart. He's changing, believe it or not, those rough edges. And you don't have any like I do, but there are rough edges that he is changing. He's melting you. And he's removing all of the things that would inhibit his purposes and plan. So that when you speak, people will know it's Jesus coming out of you. It's Jesus. It's his love. It's his compassion. It's his correction. It's his care. He's washing you, honey. He's changing you. He's making you into the woman of your destiny, of your purpose. He's turning you into what he created in the beginning. I love you. And I pray that you receive it in a deep way, what I'm saying. And all the barriers are washed away by a big and great flood. Thank you for letting me wash your feet. I love you. All the dirt is being washed away. I love your feet. I bless your feet. I kiss your feet. Thank you for letting me serve you. And pray that I do better. And the burdens of ministry will not inhibit me from serving and loving you more and our family. And that Jesus, I can't do it. I can't do it. But Jesus would just flow like a river out of me. I love you.
I didn't watch daddy.
Me and Sophia are going
to watch the river.
Don't tickle.
I got
Jeremiah was.
What? No,
you got beautiful feet, Daddy.
Thank you. Thank you, Jeremiah. I love you guys. See, you guys so wanna serve and love on me.
Just to make
me better. That's right. You are making me better. Thank you. Thank you, guys. You're awesome. Great ideas.
I just love your feet, Daddy.
Finally, CJ's coming in. Yay! I love you guys. You're so special. I'm so blessed.
Okay.